Hello, I'm Andi, and I'm going to read to you a weekly horoscope from November the 19th up to November the 25th. And this is for you coming from Taurus. So let's start with November the 19th. Now, it's not going to be a very friendly day because morning and afternoon period, there are planets who tend to make you arrogant and be criticizing others, and the teamwork going to be very poor and you could be isolated. So why don't you, having listened to me, do the opposite? Be appreciative, be supportive, be kind, talk about nice things to other people, whether they are family members or friends, or you're going out with business people or your bosses. Go the nice way in the morning, afternoon period, in fact for the whole day. Because I see the way the planets are aligned, they want to make the 24 hours of this November the 19th not very good for you. Evening and nightfall becomes worse, where your behavior can show temper, can be rebellious, can be uncooperative, and all these things will bring a lot of unhappiness and of course a lot of problems if you're socializing with others. If you really don't have to socialize and if you feel in a difficult mood, just go back to the safety of your own home. November the 20th, Monday, starts very, very well. You're going to get good news at your place of work. You're going to find there's no traffic problem, and you're going to be very happy at your business area as well, making very good contacts, getting good news in the business sector. Chase for your contracts, make good business contacts, go out for lunch, even with your colleagues. There's a lot of bonding to be done, or go out with your marriage and family people for lunch, or even your romance person. And a lot can be done for you. It's such a good two planets sitting there who want to show happiness for you and success for you. During the evening and nightfall period, there is one very fast planet who brings about the quickness where you can make mistakes, whether it's miscommunication, whether it's miscalculation, whether it's made a promise and cannot keep it. And these kind of things are going to bring stress and anxiety on you. So you have to think carefully what you plan earlier part of the day. Otherwise, things are going to haywire with the plans going all over the place in the evening nightfall period. Confusion will arise. Don't argue as well. So go methodically and tell yourself, I have to plan what I'm going to do in the evening nightfall period, and things will be under control. November the 21st are planets which tend to make you dominating, make you stubborn, make you pushy, make you demanding. It's nothing to do with bad temper. It's just a nature of wanting to get things done. And so others will find you extremely bullying or very pushy. Take the soft approach is better. Make it clear that we have deadlines to meet, or that we have got to get things done, or some situations have to be corrected. Make it a point. But take the soft approach and definitely don't want to dominate. Otherwise, when things go wrong in this morning and afternoon of November the 21st, you will be the one to be blamed. So be part of the teamwork would be better. Evening and nightfall period becomes very good for you. Oh, you'll find all the solutions you couldn't find earlier part of the day. You'll find that finding romance or meeting people you like, or even those who can help you in business or enhance your job, give you more opportunities. So be out and about. You don't want to be stuck in your place or in your home. Be out and about, look well and dress well. There's something very lucky waiting for you to happen. And you have to be prepared for this. Otherwise, it'll just be a little bit of enjoyment and you go home with nothing. So go all out and project yourself, and you will do very well in the evening nightfall period of November the 21st. We'll move to November the 22nd. And the situation for the morning afternoon is not looking good. Things are not going your way. Support is not coming at work. In business, bad news comes. And whatever you try to do goes wrong, basically. However much you plan, these planets will try and change everything. And so you will have to be a person to be overcautious. Basically, don't be impulsive. It's a planet that makes you very impulsive. So if you can control that part of it, you've got 50% of the problem solved. And then don't be rebellious. Rebellious means play along, be a team player. don't want to change plans, want to upset the apple cart, no. And that way you will control the morning and afternoon period and make it much better. But watch out, these planets are very fast, so they bring sudden and unexpected problems or bad news quickly. Evening nightfall period of November the 22nd is very good. It makes you think of holidays, perhaps you are already on a holiday. It brings travel plans to be spoken of and to be planned. People of another country, people from another race are very friendly to you. So get onto the internet, try to connect to business from abroad, try to connect with people who are foreigners, or even in your own place locally, you will find that you are becoming very lucky. There is an air of success about you in the evening nightfall period. So definitely you want to socialize, definitely you want to be out and about. So a very nice ending to November the 22nd. November the 23rd, the whole 24 hours have a bit of problem here and there. Morning, afternoon is where arguments and quarrels, differences of opinion, miscalculations, misinformation, all because you say things too fast, you're going to do things too fast, and therefore you're not going to study the facts and figures and just go blah, 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 and in the end, you are going to be nailed as to not doing the right thing. So go slow on this morning, afternoon, and early evening period of November the 23rd. You'll give your brain a chance to control everything. Don't go faster than your brain. And so you will be able to bring down the problems that are waiting to happen. If you are in business, be careful. Some very bad mistakes will be seen during the morning and afternoon period especially. Evening and nightfall period also remain bad. Now, morning, afternoon, the fastest planets in the universe are there. So, boom, they're moving around and bringing stress and you panic. And the evening time, they all slow down. And so plans can be cancelled, plans can be postponed, disappointment that way can be seen. It'll make you angry, it'll make you argue with people. So, double check all your plans that you have made for the evening and nightfall period. Otherwise, some things are going to go very wrong. Be careful that somebody from your past or people you have known or relatives or whatever, they may come your way and you'll be not feeling good about it. Or news from the past may also disturb you. November the 24th starts very well for you. You are very lucky getting up and getting ready for work and leaving for work and being at work. Everything works very nicely for you. You will have all the opportunities you want at your place of work in business, but there's one very powerful planet circulating already. This can be the planet of aggression or the planet of accidents. And either one of these is waiting to happen. Can be a verbal accident, not only physical, can be an emotional accident. So you must take the soft approach from the very minute you wake up. And even if there is some kind of upsetting news brought by this planet, take it gently, take it kindly, and that way no aggression will ever enter. Same thing when you get to work, same thing when you go to your business area if you're in business. Take the soft approach. This planet can make you very daring in what you say and what you do. And that's how the trouble is created. So play safe, be on your best behavior, use words which are soft and a tone of voice which is soft. That way nothing can provoke you and don't provoke others as well. Evening and nightfall session is what I fear the most, where this nasty planet just wants to control everything and wants to bring verbal disagreements, physical disagreements, and that of course can be very bad. It will spoil the social atmosphere. So if you feel that there may be some people there you want to avoid, just don't go there. Go back to your home. But if you have to be there, be on your best behavior. Do not provoke by body language, by your body language or your words or your actions. Otherwise, things are going to get very bad and accidents can also take place evening and nightfall session of November the 24th. November the 25th is very good. It starts your Saturday in a very friendly, very happy way. So you're going to be lucky in some way or another. Try your luck if you're chasing for a romance. Go out with your marriage and family people. You're going to meet other nice people too. because it's the planet of travel. So along the way you can meet. If you are planning travel, it's going to be very nice and comfortable for you. Talk of holidays and travel, I can see, are going to take place. So it's a very nice atmosphere in the morning, afternoon and early evening period. The night time is okay. Evening and night time is fine, but there's a planet who might make you a bit touchy, a bit oversensitive, a bit egoistic, wanting to take charge, not happy if your plans are not followed. Well, don't allow any of this to happen because they're on the negative side. Just let other people take charge. Let other people's plan, and you will see that everything goes very nicely for you because you will not be involved. It's a question of being involved in the evening nightfall period, and that's how the blame comes. Now, I'm already Skyping and I'm charging $50 for a 90-minute Skype session. And during the Skype session, I will have known already your date of birth and your time of birth. I will be looking at your palms. I would ask you earlier to email me your palms. I will face read you. I will use Kabbalistic Tarot if you want, all this in the 90 minutes or so. And so we will discuss, and I will predict for you your next 5 or 6 years in detail, all areas of your life, age by age, calendar year by calendar year. And let's do this. Go to Facebook, send me a message. Go to Skype, leave me a message. Or email me, make the contact, and let's get down to it to make your next 5 or 6 years as successful and happy as possible. Until then, thank you and good luck.